Hello, my dear friends. If you are happy with my podcast, please lend me some money, some dollars, some bitcoins, so that I can supply more interesting audios to you. Lend me some money. Yoo-hoo.
Right now, let's go ahead and just have some fun.
Not to be racist or anything, but Asian people.
We live on a magical planet, hurtling through God's mind.
Would you like to thank your mom?
I don't not explain nothing to y'all motherfuckers. Y'all explain that shit to your mom. I don't do this shit, man. I do this shit every damn day. My mom take care of my black ass.
You will pay for what you've done. And I pray the God send angels.
But for what is this battle raging, you ask? I don't know. What stands at the center? To that I say, my soul is at the center.
Crush you. You will be destroyed, not us.
Just out of curiosity, why did they go away? What's the point of it?
When I lose my virginity, if these pogs keep playing hard to get, when I smash, I'ma play hard to contact.
Seth, how you get so ripped with those abs and muscles? Well, I'ma tell you how I get so ripped. That's from banging dudes.
What'd they do to you at lunch?
Put milk on me and put a hand up my clothes.
Fucking watch it. No, I can't do shit. You speak fucking English, motherfucker. Call me a motherfucking faggot. I'll whip your fucking ass, boy.
What is your reaction when you see a black person wearing a MAGA hat?
Independent-minded brother. Bold.
Welcome to Ward Mode.
I'm just excited to see my lord and savior Baphomet represented in such glorious Italian stone.
Kill them! That's transmit! Kill the humans! What is it? Satan!
I do hope his eyes gaze upon me, and that my allegiance is recognized. I don't know. Notice me, senpai! Notice me!
This comment, right here, this has just earned you a one-way ticket to Bloxville. So, bye-bye now, bye-bye. Drop me a postcard from Bloxville. Bye-bye.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no? All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
Yeah, I mean, you're also friends with fucking people at Barstool, dude.
No, I've never met the guy.
Not the dude Hank, but you have friends at Barstool.
I have associates.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, I was. I've been real fucking phased by women in general and fucking all this shit.
You can't show me that shit, dude, and then hit play on a fucking podcast, dude.
Yeah, that was
like,
just fucking,
what the fuck, man?
That's just insanity. I didn't think it was hitting close to home for the fucking Ange.
I didn't talk about it for, I want to say, 4 years.
I would never be able to talk about something like
that. It was
that.
About 4 years before I could, like, address. Everyone knew.
Yeah.
It's not like I had to talk about it.
It sucks.
It happened. It sucks.
Yeah.
I know more than most.
Yeah.
No, that happened to me.
You're explaining the Hank versus the fucking rat kid that's from fucking Barstool. With Tom Brady, we're also with Hank. It just is what it is.
It was also at the onset of everyone getting Facebook.
Holy fuck. So
and
yeah,
I saw...
That's mega.
It was... So pre this, you break up with girls, they literally go away. And then...
The internet came.
Internet came, and I would say, oh, I wonder what she's doing.
That's crazy.
And I didn't know that she was going out with this dude. Everyone else knew. They were keeping it a secret from me. Okay? Now, the timeline, I don't believe the time. I don't trust the timeline.
No one trusts the timeline.
And that's okay. I don't trust the timeline. But I was like, what? That dude's in a lot of her pictures. And dude, I mean, we're talking like you fucked me up.
You're like fucking.
You're fucking me up right now.
You're like this. Mr. Purcell in True Detective season 3, going into the pink room. Like, what?
Nah, dude, that rocked me for years, dude.
It's insane. It's
and
insane.
I still drive around to this day. Now that was 12 years ago, and I drive around thinking I see this dude. One time in 2015, I pulled my truck up. I was working on Van Pelt Street. I pulled my truck up. And he was working on a job on the same, not on Van Pelt, but on the same block of screws.
Yes, yes.
And my truck was just parked. And he goes, oh, hey, man, what are you doing? You're still paying? Talking to me like we're boys, dude. And I was cool. I was cool to him. I was like, oh, good to see you, man. And I had to walk in the snow.
Steering wheel just bent.
I had to walk in the snow, and I had to go paint by myself all day. This is pre-Parrot. This is pre-talking to you.
Yeah.
That day EJ called me, that got me out. He started texting me. I had a flip phone, I think.
Really?
I can't remember what phone I had. And
indestructible flip phone, probably.
Whatever you had.
You had a tune sitch or no?
No, maybe I had a smartphone. Whatever.
Possibly. 2015?
I can't remember. I want to say it's like 2015, yeah.
Yeah, you definitely had a smartphone. Then 2011 was like iPhone.
Yeah, so on my phone, EJ was texting me, but I didn't have the Parrot, so I wasn't calling any people. I just had tunes.
Yeah, you just
and had. he was asking me questions about Todd Rundgren, and like, dude, if he didn't text me, it would have been a crab swirl for the whole day.
Think about
something that happened at that point. It had happened 5 years before.
Think about it. What'd you say, pal?
That's what a Jordan guy.
Think about it. What'd you say? Yeah. It's fucking crazy to know that people will do that shit to someone.
I confronted people about them not talking to me about it.
It's insane.
And they were like, we thought that she should have told you. And I was like, well, what kind of friend are you?
NMP, yeah. Fuck.
And bro. I had to nix everyone for my own psychological fucking health. Dude.
You had snakes in your grass and you had to cut it.
I went dark and went into this shell. That's why I got this house.
You're in this house because of a Hank
situation.
Because
of a Hank situation.
And look, that's a chrysalis. You formed a chrysalis and now you're a beautiful
I had
monarch.
To go away.
Yeah, I'm going back to the ministry.
I had to go away.
Yeah, the fucking shit chicks do to guys' heads and twist it like... That's not a woman. That's not a man's thought to sit there and be like, this makes complete sense. Oh, that is textbook woman got your head twisted because you know that shit's wrong.
Hank's fucking set. He's not a loser.
Obviously.
He's a solid dude. He's probably fucking 6 footer.
Yeah.
Like when this happened to me, I lived in the timeline. I lived in
I don't,
for
yeah.
a,
legitimately
at least a
don't
month.
Know how you would think of anything else.
So I thought the whole time, we're going to get back together. Like, yeah, dude, I mean, this is...
You're living in a shell.
So I was like, we'll obviously get back together. This is just a thing.
This reminds me of like the
and
movie.
I was still talking to her. Oh, we were still hanging out, but we weren't physical.
Yes.
But I didn't realize what she was up to. And she would like cry and stuff. Which made total sense later on when I found out.
Yeah.
Because she was like torn. Because she was like, she didn't know what to do.
Yes.
But dude, I mean, talk about, oh, dude, I don't even want to think about this shit, bro. Why do you show me this?
I just thought it was crazy.
Face to face with her at a concert.
What kind?
Years later, I went to see John Cale in Brooklyn.
Sick.
And she was leaving and she was coming out of the glass doors. And I was walking up to see if EJ was in the lobby. And
what was
I
the vibe? Were you mega at that point or were you just like chilling?
Were you pumped?
Not to pumped see her, but what? Like that day, like were you just chilling?
I was having a great day.
Right. Okay.
And I walk up the stairs and I see her and I'm just right back. I'm day one.
Yeah, it's insane.
And then we had to go try to eat dinner. And EJ was like, what's wrong, man? And I was like, I just saw her, and he's like, that was a long time ago, dude. You good? And I was like, it doesn't stop.
It's opening an old wound, dude. It doesn't stop, bro. You're showing me 2,000 dogs before this podcast. I show you this before this podcast. Try to do a guest on Sunday. Show me 2,000 dogs. I'm as upset as you are with your girlfriend of fucking 5 years.
Yeah, dude.
I'm sorry that they gave away this country.
Hey, I'm just Team Hank, bro. Thanks, Tom Brady, for being a real one.
Obviously. I mean, the Poussade is, I was just trying to lift today. Me and my fucking boy We fucking lift together now. I'm obviously getting big. You see the gains. Everyone sees the gains. It's been a week and a half. We roll in there, and there's a dude there who's now going out with a chick who's being rotten to him. And due to legal reasons, he can't be in the same fucking room as him. And, dude, the kid hasn't been there the whole time we've been lifting. And out of nowhere, he gets sent into the fucking gym at 3 p.m. Brother.
And they are They are just Melvins, and they are just simps, dude.
Pure orbiters. It'll never work out.
They orbit. They do this shit. They break a trust.
Yes.
That they're entering in a relationship that they never can fully trust. And of course, it fizzled the fuck out on my shit. Of course, it wasn't gonna last. She was retarded.
Yeah.
Then it was like, oh, let's hang out after that, and then I tried again. I tried again to hang out.
Dude, I see this no different than like the same way I wouldn't like go do a job with someone and fuck them out of money.
Yeah.
Like that sticks with you for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
You getting pussy for fucking 3 months is now going to stick with you for the rest of your fucking life. And you're going to be a scumbag for the rest of your life because you wanted to get something that isn't that cool. I'm watching my buddy not even allowed to lift right now because of this. It doesn't matter, bro.
And it's tough. I'm not, I know. Your boy, he's got moral relativity when it comes to this stuff.
Obviously.
But I don't.
Yeah. Fucking pals.
But sometimes chicks do.
Yes.
And like, she was inviting me over to watch fucking True Blood and movies and things. So I'm thinking we're just in a weird thing.
She's spinning your head around, bro.
And dude, I'm fucked up now. But I would like go over there. And we'd be like sitting on the couch and she'd be like leaning on me and we're watching TV.
You're obviously hard.
Yeah, but dude, come on. I'm talking about romance.
Obviously.
But like fucking, I'm there right now. I'm literally walking out. I'm reliving right now, walking out of that apartment and getting on her elevator and us fighting as I leave on the elevator, dude.
Yeah.
And that was all before I knew the whole story. Of what's the dude's mush mouth? What's his fucking name?
He's the rat, dude.
Yeah, dude. Oh, man. Fuck Bill. Fuck you, bro. Fuck you.
Yeah.
Why do you bully? I'm just curious.
Just out of curiosity. Why do girls behave like this?
Why do they bully?
Dude, I know.
What's the point?
They're putting fucking ham and milk down Hank's back right now. It doesn't make sense. But, like, that chick, like, there's so many dudes, and they're fucking, like, bro, I'm sorry.
Could you explain to the people listening what this is?
Most people probably know. It's some Barstool stuff. The hardos will get real fucking pissed off, but like, dude, my algorithm's crazy. I fucking shit pops
just
up.
Just briefly explain the situation.
A fucking OG at Barstool who was there when they like were fucking very small. He rose to the ranks, absolute man. Starts going out with a chick who was fucking working there. She has her own fucking podcast, whatever. Went out 4 years, lived together. They broke up. And then fucking... right after they break up, some other dude who's like probably 3 years in a Barstool starts fucking banging her. And it's like, oh, dude, they were my friend groups. Like, nothing gets me more pissed off than sneaker mail shit like that.
Yeah.
I watched that trying to go to sleep and I was like, God damn, bro.
Yeah.
Virtual hugs all around. I get so fucking phased when dudes don't act right.
Yeah, it's so easy.
I remember after I broke up with my girlfriend, my fucking... in high school, my one buddy he was like, oh, yeah, dude, my bad, I banged her. Like, okay.
I would say high school, different.
Different, but okay, still, like, what like, the fuck is going on here?
When you're older.
It's insane. That's insane.
Because, like, you're like, this is, A, that's the last time I was really in love.
Yeah.
I thought I was getting married.
True.
I was chilling with their family. Like, I was like, okay, this
you
is.
You thought it. You had life figured
I'm
out.
I'm like, this is going to be my life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then that shit.
And then this shit. And yep. Then this shit.
They're evil.
And then I lost that and my friends.
Dude, they will stop at nothing. That's why we call them the Poussade. It wasn't a joke. This is legitimate.
I would
Poussade
ask her out and
they'd
be like, oh, she just doesn't have much emotional intelligence. What?
Does she have Down syndrome or some shit? And I actually love people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bad example. Yeah, absolutely insane. But either way, fucking that 3 Mile Island documentary is pretty good.
Yeah, I had no idea what kind of a rabbit hole that was going to send me down, but you're going to have to give me a little recovery time here, Bill.
No problem. I just watched the four episodes while driving my truck today.
Yeah, go for it.
Dog. Mother of fucking Christ. Dude, the thing I don't understand about 3 Mile Island is nuclear energy. Like, I legitimately don't understand, like, what is that shit powering?
What do you mean? It's electricity.
But in the documentary, talking about the nuclear submarine, and it just never needs fuel.
They have like nuclear, like the core.
Sure.
And as long as they keep that going, dude, it's like eternal.
Shit's legendary then. Why are we doing this shit with getting fucking hammered by gas and fucking electric?
Because of Three Mile Island.
God damn, bro.
Do you not understand
documentary? I understand, but it's like, dude, obviously we're putting fucking comets on, we're putting rockets on comets. Like, we can probably figure this out by now.
Well, when you say we, you imagine this we. You know what I mean? But
the good citizens.
You didn't realize that it's just the Bechtel family. And they're the ones that are building these things.
That is very insane.
You know what I mean? It's not like we, like there's like
high-tech
people. These guys are running Los Alamos right now, and the place is falling the fuck apart. Dudes are falling asleep while they're guarding nuclear reactor codes.
Yeah.
Like nuclear weapons codes.
The weird shit was like how hard, like all of this stuff happens, like huge government fuck-ups, and then there's still people just like, dude, that's what the government says. It's like, Three Mile Island, Vietnam, fucking Afghanistan. You're still listening to them?
And all I'm saying is this one family is involved in all of these things. They lobby and they push for all of these situations so that they can rebuild the infrastructure. They go along with the CIA. They've been going along since the CIA, since Kennedy fucking got killed. So I'm kind of curious what their take on that was.
Yeah, we were going to do the cast on fucking Sunday, and then I was just fucking incoherent. Then somehow, by God's grace, you fucking stumbled across.
I was just bullshitting, telling you about Three Mile Island, and then I started looking it up.
Well, the crazy part in the documentary, because
they make them look like they're a fuck off company.
They make them look like retards.
It's a fuck job, and
yes,
what they actually do around the world. They're the largest construction company in the world. I'm a fucking retard because I never even heard about them,
dude. What? It was bizarre.
In my head, I'm like, all of this shit that I'm into, they're in. And I've never, like, paid attention to their name. I've never fucking looked into the shit at all.
They're literally the black nobility of fucking construction.
Yep. Yeah, I would say that, yeah.
But it's insane because you watched that documentary and you had no idea about Bechtel. Yeah. I watched it just from the shit you've been telling me during the week. And I'm sitting there looking at it. And it's like, that's, like, a little while they talk about Bechtel and they're like, oh, they were the 51st state. And it's like completely disappears.
Yep. That's why it's a limited hangout.
That I mean,
Netflix is key on this, dude.
It's crazy what Netflix is doing. Like, they did it with fucking Ruby and Ridge.
I want to say that the Obamas are on the board, or they're not.
Dude, they have Barack Obama doing fucking like.
Now they fucked the Bechtels. Fucked Barack Obama.
That's the other thing I could tell by the fucking, like, I could tell that someone had a bone to pick with fucking Bechtel because they're not too happy with the way they've acted.
Do you remember when Obama was president and the Republicans took everything over and they didn't let him do anything?
Yeah, yeah.
That was because Bechtel.
That's terrifying.
Because Obama got the Nobel Peace Prize. Do you remember that?
I remember this.
He was only president for 12 days.
What?
Yeah. The whole world flipped the fuck out. Mm. Like, everyone was like, why are you giving this to him? The reason that they gave it to him was because he wrote this letter back when he was like in college or something like that, about how he was going to end, you know, like about how his dream of the world or something like this, like,
yeah,
we should get rid of nukes. We don't need any of this stuff.
Whoa.
At the time that he's getting this Nobel Peace Prize, the Bechtel Corporation, like that era of it, was controlling all of the nuclear weaponry in the United States.
Holy fuck. So we're asleep at the wheel pretty much for the past 2 years of this podcast.
Exactly, dude.
Fuck.
Yeah. These guys are the OGs on the CFR. So, like, my whole, you know, I dabble.
Your whole bag.
I dabble in this stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Fucking when I look at it.
A couple times.
I just sit there and go, CFR, yeah, CFR.
Yeah.
Like, trilateral commission. Yeah, that's it. That's
You're just
it.
Nodding your head like a black dude in church.
I go, Knights of Malta. Bohemian Grove, Alex Jones went there, yeah. But you know, these guys are the guys that go to Bohemian Grove, the Bechtels.
Did they build Bohemian Grove?
No, they're just like the originals.
So where did the dude start out?
California.
He started in California.
Yeah.
And there's just one dude on a mission.
It's literally There Will Be Blood. It's the movie There Will Be Blood, pretty much. Like, their first big
climb. Did you get that confirmed that, like, they were kind of loosely basing, like, pulling shit from the back?
No, I'm winging that.
Hey, man, I'm with you. I now believe that as fact, so.
I'm thinking about this because I've been listening to this book, and they're talking about the Bechtels, and, like, when the original guy, they called him Dad.
Yeah.
He.
Think about having a grandpa like that.
Yeah. He,
Fuck.
He had a steam shovel. That was a wild piece of machinery.
That is fucking insane. What year is this?
I don't know. Don't start interrogating.
I'm just asking questions.
Yeah, I know.
Like, olden days.
Yeah, yeah.
Days of old days. Battles. Yeah. Okay.
Come on, man. I'm working on 2 days of research here, dude.
I hear. I'm just curious. Sorry. It's a sick machine. Look it up.
Out of nowhere, this guy gets a steam shovel. He's doing fucking retarded shit, like trying to sell a foldable toothbrush. Like, he's doing dumb shit.
He's just selling knickknacks.
This is like after the gold rush out in California. And then this dude goes, his first big client, Standard Oil. Bro, how the fuck did that happen?
Yeah, that government doesn't make a lick of sense if you're selling fucking toothbrush and then you go to it, you buy a fucking steam shovel and then start pretty much just digging trenches.
These guys pretty much invented kickbacks with the government.
That would make sense.
It's fucking wild, dude.
So this dude fucking started with Standard Oil and then went to just fuck off construction companies.
Did a ton of jobs. Like, kept building his shit up, and then they did the Hoover Dam. And the Hoover Dam at the time was called...
That's a cool story you've told me all week.
The Hoover Dam at the time, I think, was called the Colorado Dam. I can't remember what the fuck they were going to call it. Yeah. But they had to divert the Colorado River. And the Colorado River was
you
like...
You watch Goldmine, you know that shit's fucking hard.
Parker... Goldmine, bro?
Gold Rush, I'm sorry. Back-to-back cast, bro, you know me.
They had to block the Colorado River. They had to block it, divert the water into tunnels so that they could dry out the area that the...
That's insane.
That alone's insane. But then they had to dig down to bedrock, and they had to pour concrete. They had concrete trucks pouring concrete every 78 seconds for, like, fucking years. The amount of concrete that's in the Hoover Dam could go across the country on a 16-lane highway.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, but the dudes...
That amount of work, though, Matt, like, that's fucking insane.
And there was, like, not a lot of work going on, so people were coming all over the country to do this giant project, and the dudes, like, people were out of work, so, like, and it was around vaudeville, after vaudeville time, so all these, like, circus dudes, like, all these show-off...
Thank you for telling me what vaudeville was, too.
All these, like, circus freaks were showing up because they weren't afraid of heights, and they would get in those Bolson chairs, like, the swings.
Yeah.
And... grab a little stack of water for the day, a pick and a jackhammer. Then they would jackhammer into the wall and then put dynamite in it and blow it up because they had to have the dirt clean to do the concrete.
Could you, like,
dudes were dying of heat stroke.
That is insane.
Yeah, dudes were dying of heat stroke. People were breaking their balls. Like, the book I read, I like to, whenever these guys are around, these, like, real Republican dudes are around, I like to get to read a book from, like, a real lefty.
Yeah.
Like, liberal. A real pro-Israel lefty.
Yeah.
So I read their book, because then they'll dig up the most dirt on these dudes.
True.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't like it. It's like eating vegetables.
It sucks.
I had to listen to a whole chapter on Jonathan Pollard. I was going to fucking punch shit. But.
But you fucking prevailed. I mean, it's like every single fucking job they are a part of. Like, when you're telling me they're a part of the Big Dig and then also inform me that the Big Dig was never finished, that's insane.
9/11 cleanup. They recycled the steel. They got the steel recovered.
Didn't a lot of weird shit happen with the
weird
steel
shit
recovery?
They took it right to India and China.
Yeah, we stumbled across a fucked...
We're not going to... I'm just saying, we did. And we're not going to get through it today.
We're not going to get through it today at all.
This is going to be... This is 100 years of fucking CIA and government... CIA and a private company, like, hand in hand. There's a lot of fucking dudes these guys were, like, balls deep with.
Like, they had a squad?
They would team up. They teamed up with Gaddafi. They teamed up with Pinochet. They teamed up with...
Pinochet was ruthless, too.
Teamed up with Armand Hammer, Army Hammer's great-grandfather.
The dude who tried to eat his girlfriend?
Yeah, dude.
Kinky bastard.
Yeah, he had Occidental Petroleum. That was one of the boys. But, it's crazy because when Three Mile Island happened, they were already, like, balls deep in the government. And that documentary doesn't say that shit at all.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, for 1 second, it's like, oh, they were the 51st state and then didn't get into that at all. It's like, what do you mean?
Well, the dude, it used to be called the Bechtel-McCone group. And that's because this dude, John McCone, he worked for Bechtel, but then he was Alan Dulles's successor. Not my fucking boy, dude. Alan Dulles's successor for the CIA. So, like, after Kennedy fired Dulles, everyone was like, Dulles is still the king.
Yeah.
But they brought in this dude, John McCone. And Robert Kennedy went to John McCone, went up to his face, and said, did you kill my brother?
Dude, imagine
one day we'll do the Kennedys, dude. It's going to fucking shake their ass.
Imagine how fucking fuming you are to see that fucking rat bastard.
Oh, he had to work with him, yeah. But, and Bobby Kennedy was so young. People might not remember that or know that or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, when John F. Kennedy made him attorney general, he was like in his young 20s.
That's fucking crazy.
Imagine that. Imagine, like, announcing to the country, like, this is going to be the attorney general. I know some of you thought I stole the election. I know some of you think I'm a communist. Here's my little brother. He's Blow the me. Attorney general. Blow me.
Oh, God.
And also, we're in the mob.
What? Didn't you say a dude from Bechtel was at Kennedy's assassination?
No. It's just another guy, Connolly.
Connolly, okay.
Yeah, he doesn't like the little Jewish fellas.
Yeah, good point. So the fucking, the old head of the CIA was part owner in Bechtel?
Yes. Two former CIA directors work for Bechtel.
Whoa.
There's Department of Defense guy, the head of the Department DOD, of Defense. Yeah. The State Department.
Yeah.
All these guys, it's like a revolving door. And that's how they get all their jobs. They go hand in hand with the CIA. They go hand in hand with the government.
Yeah. I mean, dude, that, like, the shit you're saying where it's like, why the fuck would they rubbleize Kuwait? And it's like, oh, wait, here's Bechtel, and they fucking just make everything.
They built Kuwait, and we armed Saddam, and Rumsfeld is in this ticket. And they're all boys with Saddam, and then Saddam out of nowhere just attacks Kuwait. Now, if he takes Kuwait down to the ground, Bechtel has to rebuild it.
Yeah.
So you can imagine how you could make a job for yourself.
So they've just been literally working with fucking.
Yeah, like how I got pumped about this was Jared Kushner just teamed up with the Saudis and Israel to build a brand new city in Saudi Arabia called like Neom or something like that.
No one needs that.
And they're doing a whole city. And I was like, who the fuck could build a whole city? And it said Bechtel.
Out of nothing.
There's nothing there now. It's just desert.
Yeah, okay.
And then it's like Bechtel. It's like, those are the guys from the TMI documentary.
I mean, these guys probably built Jeffrey Epstein's island.
No, I don't know about that.
If I had a fucking say.
That'd be small potatoes for these cats.
Yeah, I guess so.
Dude, when they were doing the big dig, one of the lawsuits was they were like concrete slabs were falling on, it fell on a chick.
Oh my God.
So they were reckless, dude.
Was that shit going on like the 80s or 70s?
I don't know. I mean,
yeah, it had it because there was one fucking psychopath, that dude, Jeff, and he claimed he worked on it. So it had to have been like somewhat recently, I guess.
I never heard about it. I just heard about it on one of the last Rogans.
I thought it was done.
And I don't think they ever finished it.
That's terrifying and scary.
Yeah. They do wildly cool shit.
Yeah, obviously.
They build like all these hydroelectric dams and nuclear facilities. They built, I don't know if they built it or they did the cleanup on Fukushima. They did the cleanup on Chernobyl.
Yeah. No, yeah, Fukushima was a different company because, like, the same shit with that. It's like they have these, like, nuclear facilities, and, like, Fukushima was, like, fucking pretty big. And they're like, yo, your fucking wall's not tall enough. Like, if a tsunami comes, you're screwed. And they were just like, yeah, we'll get on it.
Yeah, right.
Like, how are you going to get on it with fucking nuclear reactors, dude? Yeah. I really don't understand how that, like, it's literally just how corrupted the governments are that they just get away with the fact that, like, all their shit was, like, yeah, but, you know, like, we were going to get to it, but it just got fucked up.
Yeah, they built some kind of nuclear facility in India, and it fucked up, and I don't know about Three Mile Island, but something was going wrong,
yeah.
And they rolled up to go see, like, to help them out, and the Indians just had bamboo sticks, and they were trying to, like...
Coal it?
I don't know what the fuck they were doing, dude. It's just hilarious to think about a bunch of Punjabs with the fucking bamboos.
Yeah, I mean, they seem just like the most rogue company. But like,
they got one of the dudes that's in Bechtel, Richard Helms. He was a big deal for them. He helped create the CIA. He's a Bechtel executive.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Yeah, he was big on, they called him, I can't remember what they call him in that dude's biography, they call him like, the gentleman something. He's like the king of assassinations.
Okay.
You know, he was like good at assassinating people. And that's why I'm like, are these guys part of killing the Kennedys? Who the fuck knows, dude? Because Kennedy was going to stop Vietnam.
Yeah.
That was a moneymaker for the CIA.
Yeah, that was this endless money.
Helped create the CIA. Worked for Bechtel. Like, it's all the same. Like, if there's a war... These guys rebuild the countries. That's what these guys do. They rebuild infrastructure. And now, the scary thing is, now they're into data collection.
Yeah, I don't like this.
They're into telecommunications, data collection. They have a foundation. I think they shut the foundation down, but that foundation was one of the main contributors, which I would imagine makes you an owner of the CDC. And they started investing in that in 2019. In 2019, the CDC was getting weird.
Yeah, something happened right around then.
Yeah, dude. He was Richard Helms.
So they heavily invested in the CDC, and you're telling me they've taken their eyes off of nuclear facilities, 2,000 mules, and you say this. You say they get their eyes off of nuclear facilities, and then they get into data collection, and then so they were going into the fucking Middle East fucking all this shit up, and they're like, oh, cool, we're Bechtel, we're going to redo this.
Yes.
And you're going to tell me they pivot, and they go into data collection, yes. And they go into tracking people, yes. And then you tell me they invest in the CDC, and then there's all this tracking and all
I'm
this
I'm actually afraid
data.
Of these guys.
Fuck me, bro.
Yeah.
This isn't good.
Richard Helms was the deputy director of the CIA when Kennedy was shot. And then John McCone was the head of the CIA. So both of the guys that were running the CIA while Kennedy was killed were Bechtel executives.
Okay. They killed Kennedy. One of them.
I don't know, man. Yeah. They're in this thing called the 1001 Club. That's fucking wild.
The fuck is it?
I don't know. It's like a Bohemian Grove type thing. These are the guys that hang out in there's 48 people or something like that hang out at Bohemian Grove.
I mean, it makes...
I don't fucking know, dude. This makes sense. I did not have a whole lot of time to look into this stuff.
Yeah, but this shit makes sense.
And then
dude,
you
like,
fucking fucked me up before we started this, dude.
Dude, obviously, you know I didn't know.
Let me just tell you, I wrote this down. I found an old website. I found on Archive, you know, the website Archive.
Yeah, yeah.
I found like old pictures of Bohemian Grove from like way back in the day when they like, you know, first had cameras.
Yeah.
And it describes it as an occult male Republican club of elites that meet every July and celebrate at a camp where they engage in drug use, leisure, and social partying. Nixon said it was the faggiest shit.
So, I mean, dude, it's like Skull and Bones and all that shit where they did the gay.
I don't know. The pictures are hilarious, dude.
What are they doing?
They're fucking around. It's like they're out in the woods fucking around. It's like redwoods, like giant redwoods.
That's sus as fuck, bro.
No shit, dude. That's why Matt's in there like, oh, we all got to go out in the woods and do drugs. I'm like, dude, don't make a new Bohemian.
A little
bro,
too
bro.
Much dip on your chip trying to do some shit like that.
We're good, bro.
Dude, but like the Bohemian Grove shit like kind of makes sense. If you're telling me like these dudes' grandparents all squatted up back in like whenever and were buying steam shovels and building like they probably like can only like they can't talk to us.
The weird thing is that now they have their own intelligence agency.
Bechtel does.
Bechtel has their own intelligence. And
you need that.
Jonathan Pollard is he's like a whole nother thing.
Who is he?
He's don't want to talk about him. But Theranos, they got wrapped up in Theranos.
The Steve Jobs chick.
That fucking Steve Jobs chick. The dude, one of the heirs was not as powerful as, you know, they say that the families, the
yes.
three generations,
yes.
the first generation builds it, the second generation runs it, and the third generation ruins it.
Well, they can make it better. I mean, it's literally like, who knows? Who's to say?
Yeah. Another thing
it's
that,
crazy they bit on that though, because wasn't that Theranos shit like all like make yourself young forever and like all that weird shit?
No, Theranos was like, we can test your blood with just a pinprick, and it was completely fake.
Yeah.
It was a complete pawn. It was a complete scam.
And yeah, that's a shame.
And she just kept getting investment. It was kind of like that WeWork thing I watched. She just kept getting higher and higher dudes. She had Kissinger, Clinton. She had everybody. Kissinger's a big dude with the Bechtel boys.
Kissinger is a fucking sick freak. Kissinger's boys with what's his name? Who's the dumb bitch that does the morning show?
Oh yeah. Well, that dude was a Bechtel guy. What
the hell's his name?
Brzezinski.
Brzezinski. Yeah, he's sick. They hate humans.
Well, and the real sick fuck. There's this dude that's a main. He's like the main driver for a long time in the history of the Bechtel thing. Is this guy George Shultz, and his boy is William Casey. William Casey was a former.
Does that sound familiar? Is that Nick Bryan related?
He used to get greased up, and he couldn't get hard.
Little pig. Yeah. Fuck. I knew that. That's disgusting.
Yeah. But Shultz and Casey were like real good boys. And, you know, so here's Shultz running Bechtel. Here's Casey running the CIA. And that's just how this has been going down.
And they're all going to Bohemian Grove.
And McCone started it back in World War II. He was like, all right, they're going to need ships. Like, you know, Pearl Harbor, whatever. They're like, we're going to have to fight in the Pacific.
Industriously.
We'll build ships. So they built like 500 ships. And then they went to the government after we won the war. And they were like, we did that. We won the war. And then they were like, well, it's peacetime now. You're going to have a little dip in your sales. And they're like, nah, I don't think so.
That ain't it.
I
wonder if they rebuilt after World War II. Like Europe. Yeah.
Well, I don't know if they rebuilt Europe, but they built the Cold War. These guys built these are the Dr. Strangelove guys. So like, they're not government, they're private.
They're in the war room.
There's no difference between, there is a revolving door between private and government. Like, they'll work in the government for a while, but then they just go back to Bechtel. This is like home base.
They did the same shit in Shadowgate. When Miller Weaver's like, dude, they just jump back and forth from private to government.
I've heard this for years, but I've never heard of a construction company.
Yeah.
And that's the thing that fucked me up, because I love the shit that they do is fucking wicked.
It's insane.
They build the shit. I'm like, damn. Obviously, people are dying, but...
Yeah, it does not make me feel good when they're going out there and it's like they have this entire track record of rebuilding after their wars, and then like once the light goes off that these guys start investing in COVID-19, it's like, dude, are we fucking taking a step over from military industrial complex to this weird like Minority Report, we're tracking you, social credit score,
well, Chinese the Bechtel, bullshit. This squad, they got into NATO, and in 2004...
NATO, that sounds familiar. Does that have anything to do with what's going on with freaking Hitler over there?
So in 2004, they told the Ukraine to join NATO.
Dude.
There's going to be $300 billion or something on deck to rebuild the Ukraine. And these guys do no bid contracts.
Dude. Come on.
What?
This is insane.
It's not insane. I'm telling you all the stuff I found out.
So, like, they're just going up there shocking, like, hey, Ukraine, probably should join NATO.
Yep. It'd suck
if someone blew your shit
up. Kosovo. People live on, like, $2 a day in Kosovo. Like, the Baltics are toasted. The Baltics got rocked in the 90s.
Yes.
Bechtel came in and was like, you know what you guys need? A highway. And... you know, sounds cool, right? Where Americans were like, yeah, sure, why don't build them a highway? 1 in 7 people in Kosovo have a car. They have an asphalt. They have like a freshy asphalt.
For no miles. Bottles.
For no reason. It's literally just one of those no reason jobs. You've seen these in Philly.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, that's why I got really interested in this, because I can relate to it. You know what I mean?
It's fucking crazy because like, from low level shit where it's just like every man for themselves trying to bid on jobs, you want to get all the jobs, and you're like, right when you think you have it figured out, it's like, wait, these two dudes, I thought they're competitors, why are they teaming up? And then the next level, it's like 6 dudes are building a highway that all do the same shit.
Yeah, like I don't know how much of this I'm actually remembering right, but I
believe everything you say,
and that's fine.
Yeah. It's your truth.
I think they built Saddam's palace.
Yes, which you later, told me that earlier.
Which later on became the Green Zone.
What's the Green Zone?
That's like where the Americans chilled. Like, we took over Iraq.
He literally just kept it warm for him.
Yeah, we took over Iraq, and they said it was like a real bad look because it's like, here's this dictator dude. And it was like a palatial estate with like fucking acres of grass and shit. And then instead of giving that to the Iraqi people after we took it over and just keeping a humble office, we like took it over. Like, well, this is where we'll stay until we
rebuild. This is my bed.
Until we rebuild it, yeah.
Some real big brother energy.
Yeah, apparently, I don't trust any war. I don't trust like atrocity propaganda and all that stuff. But they said that when they rolled up to Saddam's palace, he had pictures of the Bush daughters at his house and like porn everywhere.
Come on.
Yeah. That's why I was like, I don't know about that.
Yeah, that might be a fucking tall tale. Are the Bush daughters hot?
They were.
I vaguely remember.
I remember Fed was talking about he was down at a party in Baltimore, like a roof deck party down in Baltimore, and one of the Bush daughters was there.
Ooh.
Unless I'm getting one of the stories messed up.
Yeah. Like, good. Now,
going back to like 04.
Quick question, side note. You have an evil taste in women when it comes to like thinking they're
now
attractive.
I'm T-Mac, yeah.
No. Like, obviously, Clinton in her prime would.
I just, you know, I've always had low standards. Separate. What do you want to say?
Like, I'm not picking Clinton's daughter. Nah, that's an anti-bone for you?
Nah, that never really got me going.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I'm just asking. I just wanted to feel
you
out.
I'm just basing this on just general facial structure, dude. You don't have to get that fucking weird about it.
I'm not getting weird. I'm just wondering if you think, because she's pretty fucking weird.
Yeah, okay, man.
All right, anyway, where were we?
Yeah.
I just like to
the
know
Los Alamos shit's fucking wild, just because.
What is Los Alamos?
That's where all the nukes are. That's the underground stuff. And now this is where we get into how the Bechtel fucking executives have underground bases for when shit hits the fan.
People get killed.
And all I'm saying is, take a look at Go Blacky Techie. You know? They've been doing this since back then. It's like, oh, bury shit.
Hey, dude.
Deep underground military bases. Who do you think built these fucking things?
Not us.
I'm just saying. The Bechtel boys.
It's crazy because obviously you were deep in your work all week long. And before I was looking at nuclear energy stuff, I was looking at mountains in China and the temples in China and how they used to be nuclear reactors. Doesn't fucking matter.
Oh, yeah. You think that the DUMBs are natural?
Not natural. But there's bottomless ponds in fucking China. And, dude, imagine this. These Chinese people just confuse as fuck farmers. Like, dude, the pond goes down forever. Like, we have no idea. And someone saved up enough scratch to get one of his ponds drained. They drain the fucking pond, and there's a statue bigger than your house of a fucking person, and there's just nonstop tunnels all throughout the fucking... There's 35 different ponds. They all have tunnels.
Ancient civilization,
Before all this shit.
Amun-Ra.
I see this shit, and I'm just like, that's fucking amazing. And then I have to have someone sit there and call me, oh, you're stupid. You don't know how the world works. It's like, dude, this exists. Maybe we're all just guessing. Like, this is the craziest shit in the fucking world. But tunnels are insane. Continue. Sorry.
Well, one of the craziest things, like, that you know, I don't know why I thought about this, but, like, fucking all I remember from Iraq is Halliburton. Because he was related to Dick Cheney.
Halliburton, Lockheed Martin, that's the only thing I remember. Skunk Works.
The number one dudes is the Bechtels. They control the media.
They control the media.
They keep themselves out of the media completely.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
That is probably just paying enough money to stay out of it.
Yeah, they pay.
Or not giving a fuck.
They pay all the California Democrats and all the New Mexico Democrats because they don't want any of those nuclear facilities to get rock the boat.
Yeah.
So they contribute to all of them. And that'll shut them the fuck up. Meanwhile, they're doing a real shit job controlling the nukes. They fired like all the dudes that knew how to run it. Like, it was like scientists and all this stuff, and they came in and they were like, I bet you can get young people in here for cheaper, and they iced them. And it ended up being a $32 million lawsuit.
Dude, that's what happened in Three Mile Island when they were trying to fucking clean up the reactor. All Bechtel wanted to do was blow it out, and I have to respect that.
That's what I'm saying. Like, this is why I'm like, this is like a tough one for me because you're conflicted. What these guys are getting done, the hat is tipped. The knee is bent.
How far ahead of schedule did they finish the dam?
They finished the Hoover Dam 2 years ahead of schedule.
That
wasn't just Bechtel. They teamed up with six families. They were mocking the Chinese mob in San Francisco. They put together their own little conglomerate of six families because the bond to do the job was so huge.
Holy shit.
And I've got to respect the fucking dude that started. He said he'd never go into a deal with someone that's not 50-50. How can you respect a man if he's going to accept 51-49?
That's legendary.
Yeah, for real.
And I mean, shit gets a little hazy once you start like getting real wrapped up in the fucking military, but OG shit. But either way, back to the fucking TMI. Sorry.
Yeah.
You know that I just got a bump in it. I can talk about it on the Patreon if anyone wants to listen to that. See how my boy I got hit with a Jones tag.
What?
People were like that there's no way that's Billy's voice. They were saying I'm lowering my voice the same way Jones gets shit for saying this isn't his real talking voice.
Oh, come on, man.
I'm just saying. Just like Alexander Emmerich. Just saying. Took 2 years, finally got the comment. Thanks for that. Pretty much might as well ask me if I'm on steroids. No, thanks for asking though. This is natural. But
you gonna address the fucking falsehoods that have been brought up recently?
What falsehoods?
Someone's natty, someone's not.
Joe, don't be subprimal. You're on the couch right now. We'll talk about that on Patreon. You're literally subprimal right now. You follow no tenets.
I have a shirt on. I'll give you that.
You have a shirt on? You're a joke. I'm going to take mine off. If there wasn't two dudes in here, I'd take my shit off right now. We might just have to start Zooming so I can just have no shirt while I podcast. Because I'm not going to be in the same room with you without a shirt on. Shit's
obviously shit sucks as fuck.
Liver King. My algorithm's purely retarded. I watched Logan Paul and Liver King.
I'm fucking researching the Bechtel family and listening to Asha Logos.
Yes.
Like, what do you want?
This week was driving while watching Netflix, which is a crackhead thing to do, and I did it. And it was kind of sick. I might watch Ozarks like this. It's kind of good. My phone does some gay shit where it always gets like real dim, even though it's like full brightness. But this week I watched the TMI thing. I then watched a video on ancient secrets that no one knows on YouTube that has 2 million views. We'll get more shots in a set. We're coming towards the end. Ancient secrets, Logan Paul with fucking Liver King, and then the Hank stuff that happened, because I listened to the one thing, the Yak on fucking Barstool that comes on at one, just something to throw on.
Shout out Rune.
Like literally just something I like to watch. Hey, I'm 29, you know, I'm in the demographic, not much of a sports guy, but when it's just guys talking, I've told you a million times, I just like hearing people talk. Doesn't have to be fucking profound.
You don't have to defend yourself, dude.
I know, but I feel like I have to.
You don't.
You see how they ride me?
You don't, dude.
You see how my bros get after me?
No, I know. It's wild.
I have to defend myself.
Yeah.
I have to throw the shield up. But, dude, either way, back to TMI. That, when they were using that crane to get that shit out, and Bechtel was just like, fuck it, we're using the crane, that was insane.
I know. If the
crane fell, it would have fucked everything up on the East Coast. And the Bechtel boys were like, we want to blow this out.
Yes.
I feel for them.
I feel for them too, dude.
It's like, Billy, don't push that cinder block wall over by itself. Yeah. I'll be good.
People always say, like, Bill's aggressive at work.
Yes.
And people always say, you got to keep an eye on him. But I've watched you work for years. You're very controlled. That sledgehammer doesn't miss.
Fall is victories.
That's all
through
I'm saying.
And through.
Yeah.
If I'm going to drop a wall, I know exactly where that wall is going to fall.
It is very, it's kind of like, I don't know what the word is, like, when you're doing demo, when I do demo with you,
it's like you wheeling a spackle blade, dude. I know how to handle a demo bar.
Yeah, it just happens. The demo just happens. There's never hiccups.
It's a time lapse, dude.
Yeah. Time lapsing demo jobs would be sick.
It would be sick. I would just need more of them.
Yeah, right.
Because every, you know, like, you've been with me in the morning on a demo job, and I'm so primal that I'm forgetting
You're
shit.
You're so primal that you forget shit, and we have to use all my tools, and that's fine.
That's okay.
That's why I have the tools.
Yes. I mean, dude, you're following a lot of the tenets.
What are the tenets?
The 9 ancestral tenets.
What are you talking about?
Come on, dude. Don't be a fucking subprimal couch warrior. Not on this podcast.
Oh, man.
But, yeah.
8 grams of mushrooms.
Liver King claims 8 grams of mushrooms. And when they asked him, it was the most confusing shit. It was like asking Beetlejuice what his age is. He just says, you do mushrooms? Yeah. How many mushrooms? 8 grams. You do 8 grams of mushrooms, Liver King?
You caught me.
And he's like, dude, I'm not on steroids. I grew, he said he got a pound a year for 20 years. It's like, bro, show me the befores. Why can't I look? They were asking about his old life. He just won't explain it.
What do you mean his old life? Like,
how are you this?
How old is he?
40.
What?
40, Primal. He's older than you. Wow. You can look like him if you drink the whole beast protein shake. The dude is fucking me up because him and Carnivore ND are in, they're business partners right now.
Yeah.
And it, like, they're both talking extremely fucking weird. And like at the same time, I'm eating almost a pound of steak a day because I'm following Stan Efferding's diet. I own stock in YouTube at this point. Yeah. I believe everything that happens on it if it sounds good to me.
Yeah, right.
So currently, I mean, crushing steak. Couldn't feel fucking better, but I'm ranting. I'm sorry. You know I get fucking, I'm not even tired. I'm just like, dude, just so thankful.
This is the after workout glow.
Just the after workout. It's like, damn, this is the first time.
It's the post pump.
Well, dude, this is the first time in my entire life where I've cooked every night for 2 weeks.
Yeah, I've been doing it
I've never did it in my life.
See my thighs, bro.
I see your thighs, and you're talking about chicken thighs. Come on, Primal. Yeah, I mean, dude, besides when you start losing your fucking millions of pounds, when the fuck did you cook?
Never.
Never in your life?
Yeah, well, I never had the kitchen equipment. True. And I feel retarded for not buying it, but also at the same time, you know how I am with finances.
Obviously.
You know, I'm like PTSD'd.
Hilarious. On that. It's hilarious that you made up the price of a Ninja Foodie 11-in-1 in your head.
Yeah, I mean, I just assume these things are so expensive.
$500, no. So cheap, yeah, so man. Great. Literally, the Ninja Foodie 11-in-1 is the best thing in the world. I had no idea what sous vide-ing is, but dude, I will sous vide fucking anything. It's the best way to cook something, and it's so fucking good. I top sirloin. I eat full-blown London broils by myself. There's no fat on whatsoever. You put that shit in a sous vide for like 5 hours, bro, it can be completely frozen. Buy a vacuum sealer. It's the best. You fucking marinate all your shit and it's just sitting there like delicious treats in the fucking fridge. Why would you not want this? This is what our ancestors craved. These are the best foods in the world. And they're in my fridge. But the sous vide is literally the best thing on the fucking planet.
Yeah.
Makes cooking very easy. So now I'm just very pumped to cook all my food.
Yeah. It feels good.
It's, what time?
It feels clean.
7:30 and I'm actually
somewhat, you have more energy. Yeah. I have more energy. Look at this. Yeah. You're awake.
The one thing I did do was I'm not touching anything with canola oil.
Right.
Any of those fucking seed oils, I'm not fucking with them. Stan Efferding told me not to fuck with them. They're legit poison. This shit was like hydraulic oil and stuff back in the day, and then they're just like, doesn't go bad.
Yeah.
We can put this on shit if you want to eat it. They started feeding you this.
Yeah, man, I know.
It's terrifying.
It's poison, dude. It's food ink.
It's... All this stuff, it's like they just don't want us to live a fucking great life.
They don't know what we can be. Potential's not their bag.
Yeah, it's just, it's fucking insane how much better I feel compared to like a week. I mean, you saw me, I had a kink neck.
Yeah, you were fucked up.
I had a kink neck, I was all fucked up.
Yeah.
And now at least I feel fucking somewhat normal. Maybe I'm getting my life together.
This is the beginning.
Maybe I see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah.
I got out of the gym after I was done working out and closed the door in the truck, and I was like, things might be okay. I started the truck.
Yeah, it's that post-pump vibe, dude.
Post-pump? Maybe. I mean, I'm just pumped up that stuff's somewhat going well.
Yeah, right.
Because, I mean, for the longest time, dude.
Also heading into summer. Also heading into like a pretty much guaranteed mask and vaccine mandate free summer.
And that hasn't that feels, happened in
that
so
feels
long.
Pretty good, man.
My dude, I yearn for it. My loins yearn for a summer like I literally haven't had one in forever.
I know, yeah.
I know it probably seems like a blink to you, but a guy like me.
Nah, I know. I feel your pain, bruv.
Time's just starting to go fast. They took 27, 28, 29 down the drain. Shriveled me.
The CDC.
The CDC Bechdel shriveled me.
Mm-hmm. They are now our current enemy.
And dude, and I'm still fighting this. Everywhere you go out now, it's like, dude, it's on the table. If you're eyeing up SNIS, you're looking at her like, dude, am I gonna have to bury you at 45 because you took both vaccines and both boosters?
Wow, dude.
It's like, hey, man.
It's a possibility.
It's a possibility. It's a legit possibility. I know people in healthcare, and they're like, dude, we're having a legitimate problem with people coming in with fucking blood clots and fucking heart problems.
Yeah.
What's that from, dude?
It's fucking weird, bro.
It's not good. And guys like me and you are just canary in coal mine, obviously. Yeah, it's fucking, it's phasing me right now that everyone's just acting like this is normal. And like when all that shit was coming out with Roe v. Wade, it's just like, yeah, Pfizer was 12% effective for 1 week, bros. And you fucking made fun of people and called them idiots for not getting that.
Yeah.
That's fucked, bro.
Yeah, they had to release all their new batch of documents. Yeah.
And it's like, dude,
it's a media blitz on Roe v. Wade.
Yeah, shit, that doesn't fucking matter. Nothing will ever come of it.
Yeah, right.
They're legit shooting up people that are like fucking, they like try to adopt kids and not abort them. Like they're fucking putting bullets through their windows right now.
What?
Yes.
What are you talking about? People that want to adopt kids?
People that are like, you don't have to get an abortion. It's like a child care clinic as opposed to a Planned Parenthood one.
Oh, okay. It's like to kind of dissuade you from getting it. They're like putting bullets in it.
The soy boys from Antifa are like lighting them on fire, bro.
That's wild.
And breaking the windows and shit. It's like, bro, as a man who was adopted, you need places for that.
It's just the weirdest thing to watch dudes really get into this. It's dude, so fucking weird, dude. Like, you showed me that one Copus Eve thing, and there's a dude there, and I was like, is this the guy? I'm waiting for him to say it.
No.
And then he's standing there in the video, and he's just like, why aren't you mad? Why are you more mad? I'm like, yo, bro, what? What are you doing out here?
It's the real pandemic is fucking sneaker males that aren't standing up for this shit.
I don't blame them. I think they're just weak and they get psyoped by the Bays. The Bays are strong, dude. You have to be Hank.
Obviously.
That's what I'm trying. That's the whole thing is you have to become.
You hear
Hank.
That dude Hank talk, and then you hear that fucking other rat talk, and that dude's stuttering.
He's gone right now.
Staring at the floor like we're going to get married.
He's gone like, right now, and he's like
probably fucking someone else. Oh, right now.
Dude, you're getting me so. I'm right back there, man. I'm right back there. It's like, this dude's just about to like,
risk his job.
Oh, be like, oh, dude, it's just gonna be marriage or bust, and then he's just like, yeah, probably is. It's like, dude, no, probably isn't.
Yeah,
pretty much. Bet my house on that one, bud.
Yeah, there's probably famous people talking to her right now.
Oh, God, dude.
She has an Instagram.
Oh, man.
This dude's so fucked. His head's so twisted.
Okay, now, I don't want to take this to the schizo level.
Yeah.
But what I do in my head is she picked him because it will piss everyone off the most.
Yeah.
Because he...
It's not schizo. That's what it is.
He's a patsy.
He's a fall guy. Yes.
And she can't just... Girls can't... They can't just break up. They have to do this because it gives them the power. They take the power back to do a public relationship.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
100%.
And I know people will be like, dude, that's nuts. Love is love. They just met. They bullshit. Had out. They had chemistry. Whatever, dude.
Absolute bullshit.
I know the fucking mind of these beasts.
Yes.
And I know that they
stare them in their eyes.
I know that they do this, dude. They do this. They're like, they calculate.
Well, I mean, dude.
And they're like, I'll go out with, I'll start fucking around with him. That'll, if you, dude.
There used to be a card like, game it's like, on PlayStation like this.
It's like this. Say you go out with a chick for a long time.
Yes.
And it's all like, at one point, this is going to be your life partner.
Yes.
And then now that's over.
Obviously.
If you're not like starving yourself and suicidal about it, it's not enough for them.
Oh yeah.
Like you have to be like in their head emotionally. I don't know. I shouldn't be saying these things. Your blank statements I can't defend. But I just think this.
The hurt's not enough.
I just think this stuff that they need to break you. If they see you broken, they'll chill. But if you are just cool, if it happens and you're like, all right, and you just are Hank, you're a fucking man.
Yeah.
And you recover. It's not enough. They didn't get the reaction. They didn't get the psychological payoff. It's not enough. They got to hurt you a little bit more.
The fucking sickos.
Got to do a little something.
Takes two to tango, but fucking that dude that started banging that chick, he doesn't have a brain for that.
He doesn't know what's going on,
He got
dude.
Tricked fucking 10 ways before he even started. Before P&V, he got tricked. Maybe 6 or 7 ways.
He's
probably just the dude that said yes, and now he's on a show talking back to the owner of his own company, like, "Yeah, we're gonna get married." It's like, no, dude, you were the only
this is
one.
What
who
happens?
Went along with
Melvins
this.
Get cunt struck. It's what happens.
Cunt struck, dude. Yeah, I mean, I couldn't like just how fucking freaked out I am in general, I couldn't have that chick walk up to me and it's like, you definitely did this to fucking 10 other dudes. I'm not on some
fucking mountaintop.
Yeah.
I've orbited, you know?
It happens. But you snap out of it and you're just like, what the fuck?
What was that? What was that? That's embarrassing.
Yeah. I moved her?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Take it easy.
What?
Yeah, okay, man. Yeah, yeah, sure.
I did this.
I did this too, dude.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Guys like us. Just guys like us hurt. We just hurt just like Hank, dude. I just like, you know.
I always thought it was some kind of karma.
It could all be so simple.
I always think it's like some kind of karma for like having just too much. You know what I mean?
Too much.
Just too many girls. You just have all these girls. And then every time you're in a relationship, there's like karma in it.
Yes.
It builds up and builds up. And then you're like in your 30s and you're like, so that was like a fucking almost 20 years of shit.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, wait, do I have to pay for this now?
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it doesn't feel good. Especially when you're in the middle of something, you're like, damn, everything sucks. And you start, you run the audit and you're just like, how long would that be in karma points that I have to pay for this?
Yeah, right.
It's not going to go on forever, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's like delayed pay.
Yeah.
Like, no, we'll wait. All right, your time starts now. Now it's time for you to serve your sentence.
Yeah, I really do pray, thoughts and prayers, but I need to fucking take a leak and get some more seltzer.
Yeah, I'm thirsty. Sure.
I actually have cotton.